morning, students. Myself Pallavi Anand. I am standing in front of you to discuss some topic with you. Today I am going to discuss the class 7th standard science first chapter, that is food. I think you are quite aware with this topic, food. In class 6, previous classes also, in class 6 also you have gone through the chapter food. Growing plants, how the plants gives us food, how these foods are utilized by our body, how food gives us energy. These things we already have discussed in your previous classes. So, today we are going to discuss what is food, how food is essential for our body, what is nourishment, what is the nutrition, what are the modes of nutrition, how plants prepare their food, process of photosynthesis, equation of photosynthesis. These all are the some of the topics which we want to discuss today. So, our first topic is food. So, can we say what is food? Food is the source of energy. Food is very essential part for the human body which give out energy. By having food, we can perform the work, we can perform our activities, day-to-day life activities. So, as I said, food is very much important for the growth, development and for the nourishment of our body. Food is the most important part for the reproduction as well. As we reproduce to our baby, as we plants reproduce to their same kind, as animals reproduce, they also require food for the growth, development and reproduction and nourishment of their body. So, can we, as you know that we take food, it doesn't mean we are having food in all the different types, that is unnecessarily like junk food, cold drinks, that food will not give us much energy. So, food is required for the energy. So, we should take the food which are full of nutrition. Nutrients, full food is required for the growth and development of our body. The food which are full of nutrients like carbohydrates, fats, minerals, lipids, vitamins, these are the nutrients which is required in our daily food, daily diet, for the better growth and better development. Second topic is nutrition. What is nutrition? Nutrition is the intaking of a food and utilize it by the body for the energy. The whole process can be described as nutrition. What is nutrition? Nutrition is the process of taking food and its utilization by the body for energy. That is nutrition. In nutrition, the energy which is released by the intaking of food, that is in the form of chemical energy. The food which we have taken and the energy is released, the energy is in form of chemical energy. The food which we are taking in a solid form, as for example, we are having chapati, dal, rice, vegetables, that food we have taken and the process, by the process of digestion, that food, that compound molecules just divide into simple, soluble and smaller particles. Simple and soluble. First we are taking the food which are in insoluble form. In our mouth digestion starts and they turn the insoluble food into the soluble molecules, into the soluble molecules. These soluble molecules are easily digested by the body and the energy is released, and that energy is in the form of chemical energy. Now, these soluble molecules are react with the oxygen. These chemical molecules, soluble molecules in our body react with the oxygen inside our cell and these give out energy. These soluble molecules react with the oxygen inside our cell and give out energy. Suppose up to here it is very clear with you that we are taking in food for our growth development, and these foods are utilized by our body inside our cell. They react with the oxygen and give out energy, which is in a form of chemical energy, and we receive the energy by the taking of food. Up to here it is clear. Now the next topic which we are going to discuss is modes of nutrition. What are the modes of nutrition? There are two types of nutrition. These are autotrophics and heterotrophics. These are autotrophics and heterotrophics. It is very clear by the word autotrophs means. Auto means, we can say auto means self. Auto means self. And trophs means nourishment. Trophs means nourishment. Autotrophs can be said that the green plants or the plants which perform the process of photosynthesis to make their own food. They do not depend on any other for their growth, for their nourishment. They depend on self. The green plants depend on self for their nourishment. That is autotroph. They prepare their food, they utilize their food and have energy. But heterotrophs. Heteros means other and trophs means nourishment. Heterotrophs are the type of nutrition in which plants, animals and human beings depend on other for their food which they take. Heterotrophs are the type of nutrition in which they depend on other for their food. So, can you give me an example of an autotrophs? Yes, they are the green plants. They are the green plants. Autotrophs are the green plants. We can also say them as producer. Autotrophs can also be said as producer. Producer. Green plants, autotrophs are also can be said as producer. But the heterotrophs. Heterotrophic are the mode of nutrition which can be termed as consumer. They are termed as consumers. For example, human beings, animals. So, now you will see how human beings are eating the heterotrophs, because what we are having as a food, we are having dal, we are having rice, we are having vegetables, we are having non-veg. But can we prepare dal by ourselves? We can cook the dal, but we cannot prepare the grains. So we depend on the plants to prepare grain, and the plants prepare grain and they give us, then we cook dal, chapatis, rice, whatever we wish. For animals, for non-veg, we are having mutton, chickens. Can you say that from where that goat come? Goat also depend on food for their growth and development. Then we use that food as our own food. So animals and plants directly or indirectly depend on the autotrophs for their food, for their growth, for their development, for their nourishment. So heterotrophs can be said as other nutrients, nourishment. Then heterotrophs depend on autotrophs for their nourishment. Up to here, I suppose you all are clear. So our next topic is heterotrophs or heterotrophy. The food which we are taking, we are having the vegetable food, we are having the non-veg food. Some are having both non-veg and veg. Very easy for you, I think, that we are having, some of us are having only vegetarian foods. The plant eaters. So the plant eaters can be termed as herbivorous. Plant eaters can be termed as herbivorous. Plants, they are the plants eater. They only eat the plants. Carnivorous. only before meat to eat. So they can be known as carnivores. Third one is the omnivores. Can you give me the best example for the omnivores? I can suggest you the best example of omnivores is human beings. Because human beings eat fruits, vegetables, meat, non-veg, veg. So best example for omnivores is human beings. So the term herbivores, carnivores and omnivores are very clear to you. Herbivores means plant eater. Carnivores means meat eater. And omnivores means the person or the animals which are birds or organisms we eat both plants and meat. They are known as omnivores. Our next topic which we are going to focus on is the photosynthesis. Photosynthesis. Do you know this term photosynthesis? Can you tell me what the photosynthesis means? I'll explain you. Photo means light. And synthesis means to make, to produce, to bind up. Photo means light and synthesis means to make. So now I think it is very clear to you all that photosynthesis means in presence of light to make food by the process is known as photosynthesis. So can we little bit elaborate the topic photosynthesis? In photosynthesis, green plant, just note down that word green plant. Mostly the green plant perform photosynthesis in presence of carbon dioxide which they get from the air, water which they get from the soil, in presence of chlorophyll which they get from the leaf. Green pigment, chlorophyll is a green pigment present in the leaf of the plant, and sunlight from the sun. They perform, the process is performed to produce glucose which is energy for the plant, and oxygen which is released in the atmosphere, and we use this very oxygen to inhale. So this is here for you. Photosynthesis is the process in which the plant makes in the form of sunlight, chlorophyll, and give out glucose and oxygen. Glucose is stored by the food for their further growth, and oxygen is further released to the atmosphere which we inhale. Now, I will just discuss this topic with a classification for photosynthesis. 6H2O in presence of sunlight and chlorophyll give out 6H12O6 plus